Perfect.
You can't see it Anna, clearly.
Is it clear or?
Maybe we will increase the font once you type something and we will let you know.
No problem, I'll do that from there. Okay. Please translate this.
Jashdar e bonna ragalla
ragazzo
ragazzo
bonno ragazzo
bonno nahi bonna
bonno
bonno does it look nice now? Okay, are you able to see it?
Yes
it's visible, readable, clearly readable.
Okay, perfect. So can anyone of you write?
Right.
Just a minute.
Consider a buon ragazzo. Okay. Buono, not buon. Ragazzo hai, ending with O, so buono ragazzo. Okay. Buono means good, buona means good for girls. Okay. So it will be consider a buono ragazzo. Okay.
Okay.
Sure.
This A means and. Okay.
Oh, pastor, please.
You have to write this.
Okay.
Is means a, not is. Okay. The meaning of what you have translated will be Sasidhar and good boy. A is and, right?
Right. Got it, Rahul. Got it. Right.
Okay. Correct it. Correct it. Fast.
Yes.
Okay. So what is the translation of what we have translated now? Sasidhar is good boy. But what I have asked, Sasidhar is a good boy.
Own.
Very good. Perfect. You can discuss with me that one.
Yes, Rahul?
Yes, yes, I'm here.
Yeah, yeah. Some issue with the internet.
No worries. That's,
Can Praveen play football?
Okay.
Me and Praveen.
Both of us.
Yes. Mio and Praveen.
Try. There is no harm.
Yeah, we are doing that.
Mio is what is Mio? Mio is my. Okay, not me. Me and I both are. Me is equal to I. Okay. Yo. Okay. Yo a Praveen. Not me.
Okay.
Ah, okay.
Okay.
So, have you forgot the conjugation? What is RA ka conjugation? This is RA type of conjugation, right? So, me and Praveen. Me and Praveen become first person plural, right?
Yes.
Anybody who gets some like whom I'm adding along with me becomes first person plural, right?
Correct.
Yes.
Me and Praveen, me and Sasidhar, or me and my friend. Okay, anybody. It becomes first person plural. Okay. And how does first person plural end? Iamo, right? Are gets omitted and Iamo gets added, right?
Correct.
Jokiamo.
Perfect, very good. So, and this becomes Jochamo, right?
Jochamo.
Yo and Praveen.
Right, very good. Okay, so what I said, when it is ending with C-A-R-E as Jokare, okay, we add an additional H just to retain the pronunciation, right?
Okay.
Not run the revision. Very bad. Okay, good. It will be an additional H will get added to retain the pronunciation. Otherwise, it will be Jochamo, right?
Yes.
When we add H, it becomes Chokame.
Chokame.
So, G-I-O-C-H-I-A-M-O. Chokame. U-M, Praveen, Chokame. Football is what? Calcio.
How do you spell football?
Spell.
Calcio. 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 Okay.
Rahul.
Calcio.
Okay, same sentence. Translate the same sentence as me and Praveen are playing football.
ING.
Okay. I am not there now, so it will be difficult to play. So let's make it. Sashidhar and Praveen are playing. You both are there now, so you can play. Cool. Sashidhar and Praveen are playing football. How to write this?
Okay.
Third person plural.
Yes, absolutely correct.
Jiran.
Yes, Jiran. Very good.
Stand.
Playing the
What is Jiran? Jiran is a combination of Sare verb plus Jiran form of the verb, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So Sare verb we have to write and it is third person plural. So third person plural Sare verb is what?
Stano.
Stano. Perfect. Write it. Consider a Praveen Stano. To play is Jokare. Jokare ka jirand will be Jokando. Right? So, Sashidhar A. Praveen Stano Jokando Calcio.
Ando na? Ando.
Jiran form of?
Verb plus
Praveen Stano Jokando Calcio. Perfect. Okay. So you have to remember the conjugation of stare verb whenever ing form is there in present tense plus verb in gerund form. Okay. Ando and endo is something that we add by removing are, ere, and ire. Right?
Yes.
Remember?
This is always third person stand default. Yes, Rahul.
Perfect. Very good.
Shashidhar has a very good memory, Rahul.
Yeah. I know how to make you guys memorize and remember. You and Praveen are about to go to office at. Okay. you and Praveen are about to go to washroom.
Yeah, you and Praveen. Second plus alpha are about to go to office. Go to
Vado.
Vado. Right. Perfect.
Fiji. Okay, what do you know? Manifesto Sulpa. I'm not going to. You and Praveen.
You is? Two. Three.
Two.
Say it to say it. No. You are. You and Praveen are. Second person. Yes, sir. I'm sorry. Second
person. No, just a matter in the moment. The light rail was so on the road.
Hello, wait a minute.
To a Praveen are about to go to office. First of all, what kind of sentence is this, Praveen? What kind of sentence is this?
Second person plural.
Very good. And this is about to, right? So whenever about to is there, what I told you earlier, about to means the combination of sare verb plus pair plus the verb, right? About to, listen. Okay.
Are plus
general form of the verb.
No. This is Jiran. Wait a minute. About to the car, what is it like? Okay. It's not there. I think they didn't learn about to, right? We started, but we didn't learn it. I don't see about to.
Maybe give a find in the worksheet, Rahul.
Give a find in complete worksheet, not only for the specific sheet.
Okay, no worries. So, one minute. Jiran, we have studied here. Okay.
First 2 days, madam. 2 days. 2 days. Madam.
What is about to? About to is a combination of, again, sare verb
and general.
About to is equals to sare verb plus pair plus verb. Okay. Sare verb plus pair plus verb. Okay. For example, I am about to eat. Okay? About to eat. I am about to eat. In present tense, I'm telling about to eat. Okay? So this will be so. Stare verb ka first person is so. I am is so, right? Where? About to. Where? Plus eat. It is manjaro, right? Manjaro. So as it is, verb we will write. We don't have to conjugate the verb, okay? We just have to conjugate stare verb. So, so per manjare. This is about to, okay? He is about to go. Means?
Stop.
Kya hoga?
He is about to go. He is.
Loi ta.
Loi ta. Per.
Andare.
Andare.
He is about to go. Loi ta. Per. Andare. So it's wherever you see about to, you have to make the sentence as stare verb, pair plus verb. Okay? Clear? So try
Rahul to... here. Sorry, Rahul here. About is stare, to is per, is it?
About to is pair.
About to is per. Okay, okay.
Pair means for, right? But about is about to means pair. We will be using about to ke liye pair. Okay. So this is the formula that you have to remember. Stare verb plus pair plus verb. Verb as it is. No modification in the verb. Okay. No modification at all. As it is, we have to write. The conjugation will happen for stare verb. Okay. Just like gerund, okay? In gerund, we were changing the verb ending, but over here, no changing in the verb, okay? Clear or confusion?
Yeah. Still confusion. I need some practice for this one.
About to...
About to come.
Okay.
Yes.
So this will be
Luista.
Luista per venire. As simple as that. Come is venire, right?
Venire.
Come is venire, right? You guys have not memorized all the 86 verbs. Come is what? Come is venire, right? Okay. Perfect. Luis sta per venire. Perfect. So, what will be this sentence? To a Praveen.
Got it.
Second person plural. So stare verb ka second person plural kya hoga?
Stamu, stare. Yamayo.
State.
State, right, correct.
State.
Tue Praveen, state. Per. Praveen state per vado Tu Uffici. What is tu?
Just a bit.
Office and a singular. So Uffici, not Uffici. Okay. Perfect. So about to ke liye, what I said, Praveen, no modification in the verb, right? No modification. Jo conjugation hoga, that will be for stare verb. No conjugation for the verb. So andare as it is. No vado. Tu e Praveen state per andare a ufficio. Why did you conjugate andare verb?
To go to office is vado tane.
What is
to go to andare?
No, about is there.
Adu parre.
No, if that combination will come, then see, this is second.
A very simple formula. Stare verb ka conjugation hoga. We have to conjugate stare verb plus pair plus the verb as it is. No conjugation of the verb. The conjugation will happen only for stare verb, not the actual verb. Okay? Perfect. Tu e Praveen state per andare a ufficio. Perfect. Very good. So did you understand? The meeting is about to start. The meeting is about to start.
Meeting is reunion.
Reunion.
The meeting.
The preposition check.
There is not preposition. There is definitely.
The male gender is the. The meeting is reunion. Reunion is ending with E. Ending with E is female. Female
in
la cannot. Reunion.
Initiate. Oh my God, this is very bad. Why L apostrophe and the unknown? L apostrophe happens when the noun is starting with a vowel, right? Reunion is starting with a consonant.
Consonant, okay.
It is not ending with Ione or Vione, right? It is ending with Ione, not Sione. So it is masculine. Okay. From where did A come?
Is.
Why are you using A?
Is.
Is, I understood, but I told you in about to sentence, about to formula is stare verb, not estere verb, right?
Oh my God, meaning is.
It is stare verb plus stare plus verb, right? Simple formula, stare verb plus stare plus the actual verb, right? A is estere verb, not stare verb. You have to use stare verb.
Confusing, Rahul. Can you repeat?
I think, please repeat, Rahul.
Okay, wait. What I said, wherever about to is there in the sentence, the formula will be stare verb plus pair plus the actual verb, right? So why are you using estere verb here? I said stare verb, not estere verb, right? About to wale jitne bhi sentence rahenge, usme you will just use this formula. You will not use estere verb, okay? Yahan pe, look at this sentence. Sasidhar and Praveen, okay, are about to go to office. Yahan pe are tha na. Did you use estere verb? No, right? You use stare, right? Stare verb. So why yahan pe agar is hai, so why are you using a? You have to use sta, no? Unhone sta pe stare. Estere verb we will not use. No estere. At all. Okay.
This stuff. This start.
The meeting is third person. So estere verb ka third person is what? Sta, right? So stai sta. Siamo state stanno. Okay. Perfect. Very good.
Start is correct, Rahul?
Yes, absolutely correct. The verb is initiare.
Rahul, can you repeat, please?
Yeah, repeat.
No, I am asking you. So you told something.
Initiare.
Come again.
No, you told something. We missed that one.
Okay. No, I said we will not be using estere verb. We will always use stare verb. The meaning of estere and stare both are same, right? Estere means to be, stare means also to be, right? The meaning of both the verb are same. But same. As I told you earlier, stare verb is has limited uses. Wherever I will tell you, you have to use it. So when I am telling you to use it for about to, use it. For all the about to scenario, you will use sare, not estere. Okay. For all the gerund form, you will be using sare and not estere. Okay.
So for gerund form and about to, we'll use tare words.
Exactly. Yeah. So keep this in your mind frame that whenever a tare verb has three users. One is about to, second is gerund, and third is asking how are you? Come stai? Sto bene? Okay? These are the three users of a tare verb. Okay?
Okay.
So how many uses are there for a tare verb? Three. Right?
Yeah.
What are those?
About to, gerund form.
And asking how are you and answering I am fine.
Yeah, okay.
Como estás tú?
Como estás? Estoy bien. Como estás? Te amo bien. Okay.
Yes, Rahul.
Understood? Or any concern?
We'll write it. Asking how are you?
Okay.
Okay. Only three. This situation we can use stare word.
So you have to use a stare verb only at these three places. Rest everywhere you have to use a stare verb. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, Rahul.
Perfect. Very good. So we still have to revise. So did you guys do you guys remember all these words? 86. All these 86?
No, Rahul.
See, this is A1 ka syllabus, okay? I cannot expect this in A2 that you remember this. And I cannot ask you to remember this in A2, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
So please give yourself a target, okay? That read this. I'm not asking you to memorize this in one day. You will forget it. Even if you memorize, you will forget it, okay? So just try to read all these 86 verbs every day twice, morning and evening, as a doctor does. Okay. Just read
okay.
twice, morning and evening, just from 1 to 86, read this, and that is it for every day. Okay. You every day you will learn at least one or two. Okay.
Okay.
Sure, Rahul.
Cool. Perfect. Then any confusion in alphabet?
No, alphabet you don't have any confusion.
Okay, so basically, go one by one, okay? One by one, turn out the pages and try to revise, okay? And list down the things, list down the points wherever you have confusion, okay? We can afford to spend one more class on this, okay? On revising A1, but don't waste too much time, okay? Because A2 will be difficult, or A2 has lot more chapters than A1, okay?
Okay.
We have got the same time. In the same 30 classes, we have to complete it. So let's not waste our time, okay? Or try to utilize my time, okay?
Sure, sure.
So try to revise each and every seat, whatever we have discussed, in A1 and come up with all your confusion, okay? And we will start the lessons for A2, okay?
Sure.
See, Jiran is very simple. You don't have to use a lot of your brain. Sare verb jo rahega, usko conjugate karna. We don't have to use sare verb. He is about to go or I am about to eat. I am hai, so our intention will be I am hai. So we can use sono, right? So I am about to hoga, so we will not use sono. We will use so, right? I am about to eat ho jayega, so pair man ja rahe.
Sure. Rahul, just give us, matlab, by the time we come to the next class, we'll have a lot of revision then and come back to you with a lot of stuff.
Exactly. So let's say I am about to eat. So I am ko dekhte hue, first thing that will come in our brain is, okay, let's use sono, okay? But
yes.
About to is there. So sare verb nahi use karna hai, we have to use sare verb.
Okay.
We have to flip it. Sare hatao, sare ko add karo. Okay? So similarly, we are about to go to market. So we are ko dekke, aisa nahi karna hai ki we have noi siamo nahi likhna hai. Okay? We are about to go. We are ko dekha aur noi siamo nahi karna hai. About to hai. About to hai, so sare will change into sare verb. So Revise each and every seat. Okay, and come back to me with all your questions, confusion, okay? And try to improve your verb and try to improve your vocabulary, okay? Perfect?
Okay, Rahul.
Cool. So what should we do now?
We'll meet next Tuesday and we will that is why we thought we'll start slow so that we get some time to revise previous.
No worries. And so we can have one day class for a couple of weeks, okay? And come up with all your confusion and then because we cannot in A2 we cannot afford to lose waste classes, okay?
Sure.
Perfect. Okay, then see you on Tuesday and you can still message me or WhatsApp me in the group, okay? Or personally, whenever you are revising, you come up with any confusion. You can WhatsApp me, I will clarify it that then and there, okay?
Sure.
Okay, perfect then. Ciao.
Thank you. Thank you.
Prossima settimana, okay? Ciao.
Ciao.